Central Silk Board was established in 1949 at Berhampur in West Bengal. Except this, there was no proper research and development support in the country for the development of silviculture industry in its long history. Government of India was set up a Silk Development Directorate for looking after the interest of the industry. However, systematic organization and research in silviculture commenced only after the Government of India constituted the Central Silk Board by an Act of Parliament in 1949 to look after the overall development of silviculture industry in the country. The CSB is a statutory body presently under the administrative control of the Ministry of Textiles, Government of India. Its head office is located in Bangalore and it is established regional offices at different parts of the country. Objectives: to improve the quality of silk products wise raw silk, spun silk and silk fabrics. To develop and introduce processes and quality control measures in the production units. To improve productivity through processes and machinery standardization. To upgrade the machinery used in reeling, spinning, weaving and wet processing. To enhance the utilization of byproducts for better returns. Functions of the Central Silk Board. Central Silk Board implements the definite national policies drawn to develop the silk industry. The main functions of the board are to promote the development of silk industry by taking measure as it thinks to fit, undertaking, assisting and encouraging scientific technology and economic research, developing and distributing healthy silkworm seeds, initiating measures of standardization and quality control of silk and silk products, devising measures for improved method of mulberry cultivation, silkworm rearing, silk reeling and spinning, rationalization of marketing and stabilization of prices of silk cocoons and raw silk, organizing pre-shipment inspection of the products for export, collection of statistics, advising the central government on all matters relating to the development of the silk industry, including the import of raw silk and export of silk products, preparing and furnishing the relevant report relating to the silk industry to central government. Silviculture involves growing up host plants, rearing of silkworm, silk reeling, twisting, weaving and marketing of various value added products and services. In order to meet the new varieties of mulberry silkworm, to suit various agroclimatic conditions and to increase productivity, quality and profitability of silviculture, number of products, methodologies, package of practices, etc. have to be developed and released. In this context, Central Silk Board has established Central Silvicultural Research and Training Institute, Mysore, Berhampur and Pampur, Silkworm Seed Technology Laboratory and Sri Biotech Research Laboratory at Bangalore, Central Silvicultural Germplasm Resources Center at Vasoor for Mulberry Silviculture Research. National Silkworm Seed Organization head office is located in Bangalore. For non-mulberry silviculture research, two institutes, namely Central Tussa Research and Training Institute at Ranchi and Central Mooga Eri Research and Training Institute at Ladigarh, are functioning. The post cocoon technology related is carried out at Central Seed Technological Research Institute at Bangalore. A number of regional research stations are established at different parts of the country to deal with regional problems related to silviculture. Central Silk Technological Research and Training Institute, CST&RI. CST&RI is the only institute in the country dedicated to the research and developmental activities related to silk technology. CST&RI was established in the year 1983 by Central Silk Board, Ministry of Textiles and Government of India. Till then, Silly technology add only the status of a division in the Silicultural Research Institute in the country. Appreciating the need for a greater thrust on the demand side of the silk industry, the establishment of CST&RI was the first step in the right direction. Today, CST&RI is recognized as one of the textile research associations in the country by the Government of India. The DCTSC have the mandate of providing technical services to the silk production clusters like reeling and weaving in their command area. The SCTTS have the exclusive mandate of including quality awareness among the manufacturers and buyers. The progress of any manufacturing sector largely depends on the thrust that is provided and quality. Silk industry. The silk industry is unique for more than one reason. Silk industry is based on agricultural output wise cocoons, which are highly variable in nature, highly labor intensive, cottage based, decentralized and highly traditional, associated with high value and low volume. The approaches applicable to the other textile sectors are not just applicable to the silk industry, and perhaps this explains why silk as a textile fiber has not been researched much by the textile research institute established in the country, and thus the need for specialized research institute exclusively for silk. The nature of silk industry is quite involved and complex. It encompasses various streams wise silk reeling, silk preparatory and weaving, silk knitting, silk weight processing comprising degumming, dyeing, printing and finishing, besides the ancillary support mechanisms of market research, exports, garment manufacture and machinery manufacturing. The main institute is structured in such a way that the functional areas are given due emphasis. Research on all aspects of yarn production, fabric formation, designing, wet processing, training, extension and market information discrimination are addressed in the respective divisions of the main institute, subunits of CSR and TI and the state government departments, as well as is delegated to the research and technical coordination cell. Silviculture being a state subject, and since CSB has a responsibility for the entire country, it calls for a lot of coordination effort to ensure that we complement each other's activities for the development of the industry. The research and development, training and extension activities of the institute are assigned by the supporting divisions of the administration, stores and accounts. The research focus at CSR and TI covers all the four commercially known varieties of silk, wise, mulberry, tussar, muga and eri. In spite of the commonalities, non-mulberry silks differ from the mulberry, thereby necessitating the separate innovations adaptable under the techno-economic and social condition prevailing in the sector. The main institute is ideally located in Bangalore, the silk capital of the country. Over a period of time, CSR and TI has established 25 subunits in different important silk clusters right across the country, which serves as conduct for transfer of technology. There are three broad categories of the subunits with specific mandates to focus. They are, number 1, demonstration cum technical services centers. Number 2, silk conditioning and testing houses. Number 3, textile testing laboratories. The National Silkworm Seed Organization at Bangalore, Karnataka has a network of two zonal silkworm seed organizations at Malda and Dehradun, Uttaranchal. 20 silkworm seed production centers, 20 basic seed farms, 3 seed cocoon procurement centers and 32 silviculture service centers are located at various places in the country. The basic seed farms supply parent seed to the departments of agriculture in various states on their request. The commercial silkworm seed produced by NSSO supplements the production by states. The Basic Tussar Silkworm Seed Organization, Bilaspur, support basic seed multiplication and one central Tussar Silkworm Seed Station at Kargi, Kota, Chhattisgarh and one field unit at Pallara. The Muga Silkworm Seed Organization, Guwahati, support basic seed multiplication and production of these races through 8 both P3 units and 1 Muga Silkworm Seed Production Center at Kalibari, Bako. The Eri Silkworm Seed Organization at Guwahati demonstrate organized production methods through 5 Eri Silkworm Seed Production Centers located at Azra, Assam, Dehradun, Vasoor, Saratpur and Peddapuram. Evolution of new mulberry varieties. The Central Agriculture Research and Training Institute, Mysore, evolved and introduced a high-yielding K2 mulberry variety. In addition to this, the institute has evolved still better yielding mulberry varieties like S54, S36, S41 and S36. The institute has also isolated 2 drought-resistant mulberry varieties wise, S41 and S34. The CSR and TI Barampur has evolved high yielding mulberry varieties suitable for agroclimatic conditions of West Bengal and neighboring states wise S1, S799, S776. Besides evolving high yielding mulberry varieties, Research Institute and Regional Agriculture Research Station have also developed a package of practices suitable for climatic conditions prevailing in the respective regions. Experiments were conducted on various aspects of mulberry cultivation. Then, based on the result of these experiments, 2 package of practices, one each for irrigated and rain-fed condition, were evolved. The main impact is that the leaf yield has increased from 15,000 to 40,000 kg per hectare and 4,000 to 12,000 kg per hectare under irrigated and rain-fed condition respectively. Evolution of new silkworm races. The CSR and TI Mysore evolved and introduced more productive silkworm races like KA and NB4D2. Subsequently, the institute brought still better bivalent races like NB7 and NB18. The CSR and TI Barhampur evolved better yielding silkworm races suited high temperature and high humidity condition. The hybrid between Nistaria and Race G is large scale field exploitation with higher productivity and cocoon quality. Control of pests and disease of silkworm and their food plants. The research institutes have developed techniques for controlling and preventing pests and diseases of silkworm and their food plants. Towards the control of woozy fly pest, besides mechanical control with use of nylon lead, chemical and biological control methods have been developed. Towards chemical control, application of woozycide to kill the eggs, use of solutions of certain germicides containing the 100 to 150 ppm active iodine to trap the both sexes of the woozy fly. Use of attractants and repellents are suggested. Towards the muscardine, formalin chaff is used and Resham Kita Ausad is also used for both muscardine and grazery diseases. National Silkworm Seed Projects, NSSP. It is also significant that a number of measurements are taken by the board of ensure supply of high quality silkworm seeds to the farmers. To support the state's agriculture, seed organization in meeting the requirement of commercial mulberry silkworm seed, the board has set up a national silkworm seed project. The NSSP has organized a number of basic seed forums and seed production centers at different places in the country. The board has set up a basic multiplication centers for production and supply of non-mulberry silkworm seeds to state project centers for further multiplication and distribution to the readers at different parts of the country. Silk reeling and spinning. The Central Silk Technological Research Institute has developed an improved silk reeling charaka and a spinning machine which gives more productivity of better quality yarn. The institute has also developed a technique of cocoon cooking and reeling which help in reduce fuel consumption and create hygienic conditions with lesser smoke emissions. The Central Tussar Research and Training Institute at Ranchi has developed an improved tussar silk reeling machines. The role of CSB extension centers includes testing and evaluation of genetic materials, demonstration of newly recommended technology adopted by villages for technology transfer, survey and training with a view to transmitting the result of research to the field. Silkworm and Mulberry Germplasm Station is mandated to serve as the national nodal institution for collection through exploration, introduction, exchange and conservation of genetic diversity in mulberry and silkworm genetic resources. This acts as the lead institute for inter-institutional collection and also serves as the center for imparting training of mulberry and silkworm germplasm. Major activities of the SMGS: to collect through exploration, introduction and exchange of mulberry and silkworm germplasm. To conduct quarantine check pertaining to incoming germplasm material of mulberry and silkworm. To serve as the long-term national repository for mulberry and silkworm genetic resources. To undertake characterization, classification, registration, preliminary evaluation and cataloging of germplasm collection. To play a lead role in inter-institutional collaboration for screening, testing, evaluation of mulberry and silkworm germplasm collections and also coordinate all germplasm related activities. Germplasm collection. Collection of mulberry genetic resources and their conservation are important to meet the different breeding programs. Mulberry germplasm maintained by various units of Central Silk Board, State Sericultural Research Institute and universities including indigenous, exotic, improved, elite, hybrids, polyploids, mutants, etc. were systematically collected with available data and added to the germplasm of this station. However, the major source of collection is within the country and some collection were also made from other countries. Silkworm and mulberry germplasm station has so far collected 778 district mulberry resources after eliminating the duplicate from different research institutions and assembled most of them in the base collection with a specific accession number. The mulberry collection includes resources from 26 sericulturally important countries and 19 states of India. The mulberry collection represents 4 indigenous and 13 exotic species. The Central Silk Board has established 2 major research stations wise: Central Sericulture Research and Training Institute for Mulberry Sericulture, one at Mysore in Karnataka and other at Berhampore in West Bengal. The Research Institute for Tussar Culture, that is Central Tussar Research and Training Institute, is established at Ranchi in Bihar. 2 more research stations are established at Mirza and Titabar in Assam to deal with Muga and Eri silkworm research respectively. In addition to Central Silk Technological Research Institute is established at Bangalore in Karnataka to tackle the problems of silk reeling, processing and finishing. A number of regional research stations are established at different parts of the country to deal with regional problems related to sericulture. With a view to transmit the result of research to the field, extension center have also been attached to the research institutes. Training center of CSB. The CSB has organized training facilities to its major research institute to generate trained technical manpower for sustained growth of the industry. The board conducts farmers training programs of 2 months duration to improve the silviculture practices of farmers. In order to share the tropical silviculture technology evolved by the branches of research institute, it has organized international center for training and research in tropical silviculture. In addition, the institutes offers consultancy services in different branches of silviculture, wise mulberry cultivation, mulberry breeding and genetics, silkworm rearing, silkworm pathology, silkworm seed technology, silkworm breeding and genetics, silk reeling and spinning extension, organization, management and training. CHB training includes regular structured courses and entrepreneurship development and other skill and competence enhancement training program in addition to third country training program. The trainees from abroad are financially supported under Japan International Cooperation Agency, JICA, and Central Silk Board. The CHB has taken measures to ensure fair economic returns to the primary producer to the arrest wide fluctuation in the prices of cocoon and raw silk prices and ensure supply of raw silk to the weavers at a steady price. The measures taken in this direction are, number 1, a number of raw material banks are established for procurement of mulberry, tussar and muga cocoa to avoid distress sale and exploitation by middlemen in different parts of the country. Number 2, a raw silk price stabilizing committee has been set up to advise the board, which fixes the floor and ceiling price of the raw silk. Number 3, importing a small amount of raw silk for distribution to the actual user at the time scarcity of raw silk in the domestic market as a measure to control prices. Role of CHB and exports. The CHB conducts pre-shipment inspection of natural silk products as a measure of control over the quality of the product exported and ensuring stabilizing growth of export trade. The board has set up certification centers in the country, with one center each at Bengaluru, Bombay, Madras, Calcutta, New Delhi, Varanasi, Bagalpur and Srinagar for conducting pre-shipment inspection. As a measure of export promotion, the Government of India offers certain incentives and duly concession to the exporters. The CHB has authority to issue necessary certificate for all the schemes of pre-assignment tariff publication. CHB brings out various periodicals and publications like Indian Silk, a monthly magazine devoted to the growth and development of silviculture industry and silk exports; Journal of Silviculture, a scientific journal devoted to science of silviculture and technology of silk; Silkman's Companion, which contains interesting information about silviculture and silk industry; Statistical Biennial Silk in India. It contains comprehensive statistical information about the world silk industry in general and Indian silviculture and silk industry in particular. Popular publication. CHB also releases from time to time popular brochures to disseminate the latest knowledge and information on silviculture industry. The CHB has brings out various video films on silviculture, wise silviculture in India, Package for Prosperity, A Stitch in Time, Story of Tussar, Eri Silk in Northeast, Central Silk Board is interested to with the overall responsibility of developing silk industry by formulating the programs and policies for silviculture development and research in scientific, technological and other aspect of silviculture. It also advises Government of India and the states towards the development policies for silk industry. The measures taken by the CHB aim at increasing the productivity and improving the quality of Indian silk of all the four varieties, wise, mulberry, Tassar, Eri, and Muga right from the stages of good plants of the silk reeling, fabric manufacturing and exports. Thus, the Central Silk Board is devoted to the promotion of all-round development of silk industry in the country, and it plays a vital role in the advancement of this sector of the Indian economy.